characteristics and your attributes because it's seen by your behavior. Anytime an officer can murder and shoot a person in the back three times, hands up unarmed, they consider it as a coward. It's a coward when you shoot somebody in the back. I mean a coward, and we got a lot of coward men, a lot of coward police officers that go around and shoot people in the back, yes, or even shoot them 10 times, right, 20 times, as Stephon Clark was shot 20 times. Augie was shot in Hayward. It's happening all over the world, and it's time to stop. But you know, I know that I can't change everything, but I can change some things. Yeah. And if I can change your mind that you will not take another life, that you will not become aggressive, that's why I'm out here. I'm out here because Joseph Mathieu murdered my son, yeah, shot in the back three times. I'm out here because I want justice for my son.
Justice.
I want justice for our children.
Yeah.
We deserve justice for our children.
Yeah.
Our ancestors would be rolling in their grave right now, and they're rolling in their grave right now. Many of those that jumped in the water over the seas because they didn't want to be a slave. They're rolling in their grave and underwater because they look at this generation. They look at our nation of people and say, what manner of people are they? What have they become? Do they even care about their children? Do they even care to lift a finger, to raise their head and say, hell no, we're not going to accept it? But many of them are afraid. They are scared. They are afraid because they have been taught fear. When you put fear in a people, then you can keep them just to stand in one spot. They're going to stay there. Until you come back the next month, they will still be there. Why? Because this is what fear does. And at any time you have a police force that have to take on the tactics of putting fear in a person, are you not worried about putting their hands on the steering wheel or they'll get killed and shot? How are you supposed to think?
Right.
Rationally, driving a car, having your license, having your insurance, and being stopped. See, I've been through this. We were stopped by San Francisco police officers. We had our insurance. In Daly City, we had our insurance. We had our license. Everything was in order. But they wanted to get so aggressive. And you know, when children tell you the officer just gets so aggressive, they become so aggressive. And then, you know, parents, you know, we take the side. We try to take the side of the law by saying, well, what did you do? What did you do? But I saw it for myself. I was like, is this fool becoming aggressive with me? Give me your ID. I was not driving. I don't have to prove anything to anyone. And I'm not here to prove anything. But what I'm here for is for my voice to be heard. And each of you to hear the voice of reason. Each of you to do something about it. I can't stand here and not do nothing about it. I cannot say another son gone. I'm not going to turn the other cheek. Like I said, I don't know what kind of religion is that turns the other cheek, talking about we shall overcome someday. No. And many of them said, they said, Stevante, look at that fool, Stevante Clark, he's a fool, he's ignorant. I told Stevante, I said, it wouldn't have never got anywhere, Stevante. I wanted to give him this advice while everybody was telling him how stupid he looked. I said, Stevante, it wouldn't have never went anywhere. Nobody would know what happened to your brother if you didn't act a fool.
Yes.
Trying to come peacefully. They don't respect it. They don't respect peace. Why? Because they don't carry. They don't embrace. It's not a part of their innate nature. So if it's not a part of your innate nature, how can you give it what you don't have?
Yeah.
You cannot give what you don't have. When you are naturally a person that loves no matter what race, creed, or religion, or sex a person may be, and you show love and care and affection, that's true humanity. But when you start judging people by the color of their skin, by their sex, or whatever, have low self-esteem when we should love our neighbor as ourselves.
Yeah.
But loving our neighbors as ourselves, they're not loving us. They're not loving us. And if you're not loving me, I'm not loving you. And if you don't care about what happened to my son, I don't care what happened to yours.
That's right.
Because you should care enough.
Yeah.
You know, I was protesting long before my son was murdered. I stood up for the mothers. I stood with the mothers. Why? Because it was right to do. But nowadays, you gotta ask, will you come with me? Can you come? Can you come and protest? Will you help me? Nobody's raising their hand to say, let me call Bart and ask them, why did Joseph Mattu murder my son? Well, he told me, like I said, he said it shouldn't have never happened. Does that matter? Does that matter that it shouldn't have never happened? Did Nancy O'Malley say, well, this officer said it shouldn't have never happened? Well, to her, it doesn't make a difference. Why? Because when you take bribes, she's one of the biggest bribe takers.
Yes, she is.
She takes bribes from the police commission. They have it all sewn up. But let me tell you something. Yahweh Elohim see you. Commonly called God, see you. See your actions and your deeds. And each one, to every cause, there's an effect. You will reap what you sow. It's such a mess.
No justice.
It's such a mess.
No justice.
So many mothers are crying. So many mothers. And even children that's being taken by the hands of each other. Why? Because they don't have their knowledge. They don't have their culture. They don't know the meaning of life. But even their cases are not being solved. They don't care about our African American, commonly called children, dying. They don't care. Well, if you don't care, that's too bad. Because I can't say I don't care, because I do care. That's why I'm here. And that's why I'm not just speaking for my people. I speak for all people. All people that have the same hardship, the same burden that they have to endure day after day after day. It's such a mess.
No justice.
It's such a mess.
No justice.
You know, people say you should have so many people behind you. I'm not worried about who come. If it's just us, I'm going to stand here and they're going to hear my voice and they're going to hear this judgment. The judgment is upon you. You're going to hear the judgment. And the judgment is going to be guilty, 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 guilty. You're going to be guilty. Why? Because you was told. You was forewarned. And the warning of the judgment is an exclusive appeal. I'm trying to appeal to your mind to say that which you are doing and the injustice that you are not, the injustice that you're giving will not go unseen. It will not go unseen, unheard, no. No, the Creator sees you. Yahweh Elohim sees you.
Yes.
And Yahweh Elohim ain't in the sky. Yahweh Elohim is in each of us. And we are putting judgment on you today. We're going to do Eim, which is a mother's prayer. Because mothers are the carriers of life. The mothers are the keepers, the holders, the breath of life. We are taught not to have that self-esteem, but yet the nation of children come out of our womb. Every race of people, the mothers give birth to their children. And then for what? For their children to be taken by a law officer that swore to protect and serve? It's such a mess.
No justice.
It's such a mess.
No justice.
Well, we want justice.
Yes, we do.
Well, we want justice.
Yes, we do.
And you know what? You see the children holding the mic. I give the mic to them because we're the going on generation. We ain't going to be here always. Somebody better speak up. Somebody better be able to say, let me step out. Instead of everybody sitting there scared to death. So many fearful people. How did they become so fearful? So afraid. How did they become? They were taught to become afraid. Well, we're here to show them, no, you're not going to have no fear. You're not going to walk around and fear man. But what you have is sacred consecration for your Elohim, for your Creator. But you ain't got to fear no man or woman. I don't want our children to be raised in fear. No. We should be able to talk to the police officer. We should be able to communicate with the police officer. We should be able to have a relationship with the police officer. We should be able to tell the police officer our story and then not be changed. All right, don't be crossed out. You know, the guy that my son got into an altercation with, he fled the scene. Well, we just found out that a year later that he fled the scene. Why didn't even my attorney tell me that? That he fled the scene. Not only that, he was drinking the night before. He was drinking alcohol the night before. Why wasn't that mentioned? And said that there was no alcohol in his system, but he said in his deposition that he was drinking a couple of rounds of alcohol. That alcohol still lingers in your blood 24 hours. And you're gonna tell me that you wasn't high? They cover this stuff up.
Yes.
And then they say that the young man that was in the altercation, that he was shot in the leg. But then the police report and Nancy O'Malley's report say that he fled from the scene. What, he fled hopping or running? And then they laid him on the ground with his hands behind his back after they apprehended him. There was no blood on the concrete. So who's speaking the truth?
Liars.
But you know, they think that I'm one of the same parents, that it's all about the money. I'm out here for justice. You cannot replace my son with no amount of dollar. But you will compensate. Oh, yes, you will. You will compensate. It's such a mess.
No justice.
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 I appreciate each and every one of you for coming out here to speak up, to speak out, to have a voice, to have something to say. All those that are listening, why don't you call Bart and say, how long do these people have to keep asking for justice? How long? I know we see these people, they're peaceful. They try to say that we wasn't peaceful. They lie. They wrote in the report, the reporter wrote me and called me the next day and say, well, Miss Banks, they said that you wasn't peaceful. But the BART commuter people said that you were.
Right.
So who's the liar?
Right.
They can write what they want to write. They can report what they want to report. And people will accept it because they don't seek out nothing for themselves. Well, the BART police, Joseph Matu, you murdered my son. You took his life and you lied. You said that he pointed a gun at you, and I thought that was the true story. I said, well, if my son pointed a gun at the police, then wow, yeah, of course they would shoot him if he's pointing a gun at the police. No, but it wasn't true when I seen the body cam, which crushed me, knowing that he was shot in the back. And they lied, shot in the back 3 times. How do you think I'm supposed to feel? I was trying to think rational, as a mother would do. A mother, a true mother that loves her children, is going to tell them the truth, no matter what. Just as I said, I don't teach my children to hate cops. No, because you got good and bad cops. You got those in the Oval Office that's good and bad. But it's trickling down because there's no discipline. There's no spiritual discipline. Nothing spiritual going on in the White House. Nothing spiritual going on in the police force. There's nothing spiritual nor moral. Not even moral. They're losing their morals. You got sex trafficking that's going on, even with the police involved. And Rojas, Carlos Rojas, the chief that resigned. As we start coming, he retired. But we found out that he was kicked out of Santa Ana as the chief of police and come way over here to become chief of police. Called him a hero for murdering my son. How's a man a hero? When you kill somebody, you don't call them a hero. No, you call a person a hero when they save lives. and that should be their thought of them saving lives. What happened to de-escalation? When I went to the board meeting, I said, did Joseph Mattu have a psychological evaluation? Every time I went, I asked the same question. Finally, months later, they gave him one because I kept asking, did he have a psychological evaluation? Joseph Mattu, after meeting with him, not knowing that I was going to meet this man, I didn't know his face, couldn't put a name with a face. I met him and my lawyer said, do you want to sit in the same room? I said, I want to sit at the same table. I showed him pictures of my son commemorating child of ability, child of accountability, child of the law. I showed him when we went on vacations, when we went to Mexico and other places that I have taken him to and family. Taught him how to be a man. Told him, stay with your children. Raise your children. I don't care. Get along. Raise your children. He'd been with the same girl for 14 years. They had two children walking to BART. Joseph Mattu. I stood there and I showed him pictures of my son and of his children. And I asked him, I said, how did you feel after murdering my son? He said, my life has not been the same. And he cried. He said, it shouldn't have never happened. And it shouldn't have never happened. What happened to de-escalation? I told him, it shouldn't have never happened. But it did. But I said, remorse without penalty is not true remorse. If you're not penalized, even with your children, and say, train up a child in the way they should go. And if that child is not disciplined in some form, taking something from them, not allowing them to watch TV, to get off their phone, if they're not reprimanded, then they will continue to get wild and they'll become wild with you. The same principle applied to the police force. If they're not reprimanded, then they feel that they can do what they want, kill who they want, hurt who they want, brutalize who they want, say what they want, it will continue to happen. But do I teach my grandchildren and children to hate the police? Hate beget hate. I wouldn't teach them that. Because one day we may have to call the police officer. But then you have those that are in the force, that have become the force, that have become aggressive force. Their nature have taken on that ideology to become aggressive. What kind of nature is that? What type of nature is that? Well, it's happening every day. And we're going to continue to stand. Nancy O'Malley, they wrote in the report that they said that my son had a gun, but then they turned around in the report and wrote there was no residue on his hands. But they said the one that he got into a confrontation, which men and women get in confrontations every day. Husband and wives, look at the football guy. Got into a confrontation with his wife. People, these things happen. But does it mean that a police come and murder them? Their life should be taken because they didn't got into an argument? No, it don't mean that they should die. What happened to de-escalation? That which they supposed to practice. That is the first practice is to what? To de-escalate. Why didn't they try to de-escalate? Why did he run from BART all the way to from 9th to 7th Street to kill him? With his back turned. His back was turned. I didn't know his back was turned. It hurt me, it crushed me when I saw that his back was turned.
Yes.
With no gun.
Shot in the back.
Hands in the air.
Coward.
And when he went down, he said, show your hands, show your hands.
That's what he
was. And he went down, showing his hands. And he said, I didn't start it. He started it, the guy. But also in the police report, it says that the guy fled. Well, they didn't write that in the stories when it was told.
No,
that the other guy fled from the scene that they had to go and apprehend him. It also said in the report that the residue from the forensic report was on the guy's hand. Does that mean anything? It wasn't on my son's hand, but it was on his hand. Who shot the gun?
Right.
He fled from the scene, but he was shot in the leg. They still won't tell me his name. They don't want me to know his name. You know why? Because he was an informer for BART. He was a panhandle out here. They used to let him panhandle. Everybody knew him. Everybody saw him. So, of course, the story is on the dead person. The dead person, which is my son, could not speak for herself. So I'm out here to speak for him.
That's right.
And I'm going to keep speaking for him. And they're going to keep hearing truth. And I'm going to continue to stand.
That's right.
I'm not here to tear down their building, but I'm here to tear down their lies. I'm here to tear down their false doctrine. That's what I'm here for. I'm not here for no other reason. Not to be seen, but to be heard. And that's the only reason why I'm here. And I'm going to continue to stand here, and we're going to continue to come, the Hebrew culture community, we're going to stand for Shalim. Hakikawa Shalim!
Hakikawa Muku Shalim!
Hakikawa Shalim!
Hakikawa Muku Shalim!
It's such a mess!
No justice!
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 But we want justice!
Yes, we do!
But we want justice!
Yes. Yes, we do.
But we want justice.
Yes, we do.
But we want justice.
So should you.
Channel 2, Channel 4, Channel 5, Channel 7, they all came out. I said the things that I needed to say about what happened. You know what they got? They got me wiping my eye. They didn't even have a sound bite of what I said. They got me wiping my eye because they always want to look like the woman. All she does is cry tears. But a woman is strong. She's the carrier of all nations. She carries her children in the womb. No race could be here without a woman. And therefore, if you think for 1 minute we're not going to stand for our children and we're not going to speak the truth, well, you got another thing coming. I don't have to say. I just put judgment out there and it will return. It will return. You reap what you sow. And that which you sow is wrong. And that which you continue to sow is wrong. Some of you should ask the question. Some of you should make some noise. You know, I don't do things that like other people. You know, they go tear up stuff, but that's all they know. When their language and their culture and all been taken, well, what else do they know? You take their language, you take their culture, and you ask why. Well, that's why. You take their mother tongue, their communication that they only have, and their ceremony rites. What else do they have? What do you expect for them to be? You helped made them who they are. And then you go and put your foot on their neck. But do we retaliate? No, because we are a people that love everybody. We love everybody, but I tell you one thing, we're not turning the other cheek.
No way. No.
You come to Maria in a better place, what better place is there? You ain't been to heaven, you don't know what it's like.
Thank you.
But I don't care, you had two children here on earth and a companion on her earth. And this is where we saw them tangible, where we could touch and feel and hug and love. And you talking about, oh, you're in a better place. What better place is that? You ain't been to heaven. The better place was for him to be here with his two children. The better place is he should have never been shot in the back 3 times. No, he shouldn't have never been shot. Well, you got the coming on, the moving on, and the going on generation. We're going on. Okay, who's going to be there for the coming on generation? If no one speaks up, no one speaks out, if everybody is afraid because of fear, fear have stopped many men and many women from doing certain things. Fear have stopped many people from accomplishing things. Why? Fear. Well, I'm not afraid.
Not at all.
I live life and life more abundantly. I'm rich in spirit. And I'm going to stay rich in spirit. And most of all, I got my freedom.
Yes.
I have my freedom to go where I want, when I want, and do as I choose to do. But I do it in righteousness.
Yes.
I do it in truth.
Yes.
I don't kick it. I don't do no kicking it with young people. But what I do is teach. My son helped build my ranch. He helped build my chicken coop, where I give my eggs out to the community. He helped build my fence that holds my sheep and my goats in. He helped my water my garden, pave the ground, cement the ground. He was very useful with his hands. He helped me do a lot of things at the ranch. His children would come and swim and play and jump and play with the animals. Now they come up, I have them up all the time. They say, where is my dad? I say, your dad is in you.
Yeah.
Your dad is still here, he's in you.
Yeah.
You be the best part of your dad now.
It's all right. It's all right.
From the day that it happened, I've been phone call, writing letters, running, protests. Almost 2 years, I have not stopped. But every time I begin to talk about it, it brings such a sadness. He was still growing. He was still maturing. He wasn't, you know, person say, well, you know, he shouldn't have never got shot. No, he shouldn't have. But he was still maturing. He was only 28 years old. You have men that's 50 and 60 years old that have not ripened. Women that 50 and 60 that have not ripened. You know why? Because it's a lack of knowledge. No one is really teaching our girls and our young men how to be real men, how to stand and take care of their family. Well, I raised 6 children and I taught every last one of them. You stay with that woman. They gave birth to your children. And all of my sons, my daughters, still have communication, still with their family. Because this is the way I raised them, and I'm raising other families to do the same. Marry that woman. They got to hear that. Oh, it's okay, just have a baby out of wedlock. Teach them about ceremony rites. And you think that we're not lacking so many things, we're lacking so many things. Why? Because things have been taken from us. But we're here to regain it. We're going to do the prayer im, which means mother, in Yiddish. Raise your yards, Hebrews.